Hello dear students, welcome once again to our channel Maths in Minutes with Priya. Today is turn of time and work part 3, that is clip 53. I really hope that you watched first two parts wherein we have covered a very different method to solve time and work problems known as LCM method. If you have already watched first two parts, it's very easy method. It's different than what we have been learning since school days. It's very different method, but that method helps us to avoid fraction operations. So it's my wish that you first watch part 1 and part 2 and then start watching part 3. It will help you to understand part 3 fast and better. So let's begin with part 3. Today we are going to do questions based on efficiency. In this particular chapter, time and work, many times you must have read this word efficiency. A is twice efficient than B, those type of questions. So let's understand what is meaning of that. So when I say A is efficient than B, what would it mean? By common sense, what would you say? Would you say that A is faster than B? Yes, A is efficient than B. That means A works fast. That means time required for A will be less than time required for B to finish a particular work. Am I right? So that is the meaning of efficiency. Got the meaning? Anita is 20% more efficient than Bina. Anita can alone complete the work in 33 days. If they work together, in how many days will they complete the work? Now here, we are not given individual capacity of Bina. We have given individual capacity of Anita. Anita can alone complete the work in 33 days. That much we know. But we don't know in how many days Bina can complete a work, right? But what they have mentioned is Anita is 20% more efficient than Bina. What is meaning of 20%? 20% is always 20 per 100. So that means if Bina in one day completes 100 units, Anita will complete 120 units. 20%, 20 per 100 more. That means if Bina in one day completes 100 units of work, Anita in one day will complete 120 units of work. If you remember, we have solved many percentage problems or even profit and loss problems. If we assume base as 100, whenever the percentage is mentioned, if we assume base as 100, things become very easy. So in same manner, we are going to solve this sum also. So as you can see, percentage is many times used as operator. Just like plus, minus, multiplication, division, percentage is also used as operator. So it's very important that you are fluent in finding percentages and understanding the meaning of percentage. What I suggest is, I have uploaded 3 videos on percentage sometime back. I don't remember the clip numbers, but please watch that if you are not able to understand how to find percentages. It is very important that you know how to operate percentage. So coming back to our sum, Bina in one day completes 100 units, Anita in one day completes 120 units. So if they work together, in one day they will complete 220 units. 100 plus 120, 220 units. What else is given to us? Anita can alone complete the work in 33 days. So in 33 days, how many units of work will be there completed by Anita? See, in one day she completes 120 units. So in 33 days, she will complete 120 into 33. And this is the total work units. 120 into 33 units. This much work will be finished by Anita. And this is the total work, because they are saying she finishes the work in 33 days. So this is the total work. Now the question is, in how many days will they complete the work if they work together? This is the question. Now it's very easy. Look here. (Clears throat) Anita and Bina together, in one day they finished 220 units of work. 220 is finished in one day. So this much units is finished in how many days? Now what we want? We want how many days will they take if they work together? What we know is if they work together, in one day they finish 220 units. So 220 units finished in one day. These many units finished in how many days? This into this divided by this. So 120 into 33 into 1 divided by 220. Very simple product, 18. So answer is 18. One advantage of time at work is this: numbers are always very easy for finding factors, for cutting zeros, taking the product numbers, taking LCM. Numbers are generally very easy. The only thing is you should understand the approach. So whatever is given to us, how we can approach this question? If they work together, in how many days they will complete the work? So what first we did? First we found out in one day they will finish how much? So together they will finish 220 units. So if we know the total number of units, only then we will be able to find total days. So for finding that, we must use this information, isn't it? So that's how the approach of this sum is. These sums are very easy. Just read it twice and you will understand it. It's very easy. Let's solve some more sums. Akbar is twice as good as a workman as Birbal. Birbal takes 25 days more than Akbar to finish the work. In how many days they can complete the whole work together? Now in earlier sum they had mentioned the word efficiency. Here they have not mentioned that particular word, but what they have given us? Akbar is twice good as workman. Means what? Akbar is twice efficient. That's the meaning if we use the word efficiency. So don't get confused with change of language. The meaning is one and the same. So procedure is also going to be one and the same. Since Akbar is twice efficient, what we can do? If Birbal in one day finishes 100 units, Akbar in one day will finish 200 units. Correct? Because it's twice efficient, twice as good workman as Birbal. So that means if Birbal in one day finishes 100, Akbar in one day will finish 200. As simple as that. Now in earlier example, we were given that Anita finishes the whole work in 33 days. So some number of days were given to us. But this sum is little difference. What they have given us? Birbal takes 25 days more than Akbar. So actual number of days are not given to us. So what we can do here? Let Akbar finish the work in X days, that we can assume. And Birbal takes 25 days more. So that means Birbal takes X plus 25 days. And now we need to find X. So we need some equation. How can we form the equation? See, I'm talking these many lines. It's like I'm talking to you so that you understand the approach. What to assume, how to form the equation. The main problem of student is they don't understand how to solve the word problems, how to form the equation. And that's why I'm talking to you, that what I'm thinking, whatever I'm thinking, I'm talking to you so that I'm telling it to you so that you can also understand. So what we have assumed here, Akbar in one day 200, Birbal in one day 200. And also we have assumed that Akbar finishes work in X days and Birbal finishes work in X plus 25 days. And now we have to form the equation. Very simple it is. Look at this line. In one day Akbar finishes 200 units and he is working for X days. That means total work is 200 into X. Correct? And the same work is finished by Birbal if he completes 100 units in a day and he works for X plus 25 days. So 100 into X plus 25. So 200 into X is same as 100 into X plus 25. Understood the meaning? Now open this bracket and solve. 200x is equal to 100x plus 2500. Take 100x on this side. So 200 minus 100, that is 100x is equal to 2500. So x is equal to 25. Now can we find the total work? What will be total work? Put x here. 200 into x, that is 5000 units. You can also put x here. Still the answer will be 5000 only. So total work is going to be 5000 units. Now what we want? In how many days will they complete the work if they work together? Now what do we know? In one day, if they work together, they will finish 300 units. That much we know. Correct? And total work is how much? 5000 units. So 300 units is finished in one day. 5000 units is finished in how many days? 5000 into 1 divided by 300. This is question mark. 50 upon 3 days. You can also convert it into mixed number. 16, 2 by 3 days. See, you need to be very fast in this convergence. I keep telling you this, that if you are not fast in this convergence, your speed will be very slow in the exam. So please practice this convergence also. I have made one video on this topic also, convergence of fractions into decimals, mixed numbers. So please practice it. Watch that video and keep practicing. You should be very fast in this convergence. So your answer is 16, 2 by 3 days. Very easy. Both these examples, the approach was exactly the same, but only here additional thing, we had this x unknown. In earlier example it was bit easy, here there is additional x, but the procedure is same. If you again read this procedure of both examples, you will understand it immediately. Let's move to the next example. A takes time twice as much as B, C takes time thrice as much as B. So now there are three people. If they work together, they finish the work in 18 days. In how many days C alone can complete the work? So here they have not used the word efficiency, but still meaning remains the same. Look here, A takes time twice as much as B. That means B is more efficient than A, correct? Because A requires double time to finish a particular work. That means B is more efficient. But instead of using this word efficient or efficiency, now what they are saying? A takes time twice as much as B and C takes time thrice as much as B. So what we can do is we can start like this. Let B take one day to finish the work. Earlier, first and second example, what we did, we assumed units of work as 100 and then 200, 300, and that way we proceeded. In this example, since they have mentioned time to finish the work, we are going to proceed with time. So let B take one day to finish the work. A takes double time, so A will take 2 days, and C takes time thrice as much as B, so C will take 3 days. 1 day, 2 day, 3 day. So now if you have watched first two parts, you must be remembering this procedure. What we do? We take LCM. LCM is 6. So we are going to assume let units of work be 6. And then we do this division. A take 2 days to finish 6 units. That means in 1 day, A will finish 3 units. Which plain division. We do this division. So B in 1 day will finish C unit, A in 1 day will finish 3 units, and C in 1 day will finish 2 units. 6 divided by 3. Please watch part 1 and 2 to understand this concept if you have forgotten. So we already found out that in 1 day how much work they are finishing. So if they work together in 1 day, they will finish 11 units. Up to this step, clear? Now they have also said that if they work together, they finish the work in 18 days. Now, in one day, they are finishing 11 units. So, in 18 days, they will finish 11 into 18 units. So, that means total work is 11 into 18 units. Up to this step, clear? Now, what is the question? In how many days C alone can complete the work? Now, we already have. How much is the work? Work is 11 into 18 units. And C in one day finishes 2 units. Both these pieces of information we have. So what we how we can use it? 2 units are finished in one day. 11 into 18 units finished in how many days? 11 into 18 into 1 divided by 2 cross multiplication. So solve this. 11 9s are 99. So C, if he works alone, he will take 99 days to finish the work. If we had question about A, how will you solve? Here the question was about C, but if they ask question about A, then same method. A in one day finishes 3 units and total work is 11 into 18 units. So 3 units in one day. 11 into 18 units in how many days? 11 into 18 divided by 3. Same like this. So whatever the question may be, your procedure is going to remain same. And now you must have noticed that how easy these examples are. We just assume few basic things, then we get total work and then we perform the division. No fractions, numbers are also very easy. So you can perform these sums orally once you understand these basics. What are we actually doing? It may take some time to understand this, but once you understand, then this time and work examples will be very easy. You can solve them orally. Let's solve some more examples. 12 men and 8 women complete work in 9 days. Each woman takes time twice as much as men. If only men decide to finish the work, then in how many days will they finish the work? So instead of mentioning A, B or Lina, Meena, now we are going to talk about men and women. So 12 men and 8 women complete the work in 9 days. This is given to us. And one more thing is given to us is efficiency. Each woman takes time twice as much as men. That means who is more efficient in doing in this particular work? Since woman requires double time, that means she is slower than man. So that means man is more efficient. But only in this particular example. In real life, women are more efficient. Isn't it, girls? So let's solve this. So since they have mentioned that woman takes time twice as much as man, what I'm going to assume, let man in one day finish the work. The man finish the work in one day, so woman will finish the work in 2 days, correct? Days. So what is the next step? Next step is always find the LCM. LCM of 2 and 1 is 2. So units of work, let units of work be 2. Second step is what? Correct, division. So man in one day will finish 2 units, woman in one day will finish 1 unit. Just the division. But now, what we have is, man in one day finishes how many units and woman in one day will finish how many units that we have. And they have also given us number of men and number of women that are working for 9 days to finish the work. So how we can make use of this information? There are 12 men. Now one man in one day finishes 2 units. So 12 men in one day will finish 24 units. Correct? And they are working for 9 days. So total these men will finish 24 into 9 units. Now there are 8 women. One woman in one day finishes 1 unit. So 8 women in one day will finish 8 units. And they are also working for 9 days. So 8 into 9. So this much part is finished by men and this much part is finished by women. This will be the total work. What we can do? We can take 9 as common factor. in the bracket 24 plus 8. So this will be 9 into 32, 32 into 9. These many units of work. So total work finished by men and women in 9 days will be 32 into 9 units. This is the total work. Got it? So now we know how much is the total work. In last example also, or the example that we solved before also, what we did, we first found out total number of units of work. So here also we did the same thing. Whatever information was given to us, from that we found out that how much is the total units of work, that is 32 into 9. Now we will move to the question. They are saying, if only men decide to finish the work. So what these men are saying, that women are slow, so let's not involve women in this. Let we all finish this work. So only men are going to finish this work now. Now what are the number of units finished by men? 12 men in one day are finishing 24 units, and only 12 men are going to work. Women are not going to be there, correct? So 24 units are finished in one day, and this is total number of units. 32 into 9 units finished in how many days? 32 into 9 into 1 divided by 24. You understood this step? Again, pay attention. We have found out total number of units of work, but now only men are going to finish it. Women are not going to be there, correct? And how many men are there? There are 12 men, and in one day they finish 24 units. This much information we already have, that they are finishing 24 units in one day, and we have these many units. So 24 units are finished in one day. 32 into 9 units are finished in how many days? 32 into 9 into 1 divided by 24. 8 threes are 8 fours are 3 ones are 3 threes are, answer is 12. So these 12 men will finish the whole work in 12 days without taking help of women. So if they had taken help of women, what would have happened? 12 men and 8 women can complete the work in 9 days. But now they have decided that we are not going to take help of women. So if they only men work, they will finish the work in 12 days. Example clear? See, all these examples have slight twist, but they are all based on efficiency only. I have tried to cover different examples so that even if the language changes, it's men and women, sometimes A and B, sometimes actual name, sometimes they will mention time, sometimes they will mention work. So sometimes they won't give us the actual time or work, they will just give us comparison. So in every example, I have tried to cover a different twist. In part 4, we are going to solve advanced level of examples of time and work, where there will be men, women, children, or like few men and few women start working. After some days, they leave, and different number of men and women join them to start the work. These type of examples. So please watch part 1, 2, 3 again and practice those examples so that in part 4, you won't find any difficulty in understanding or solving. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel Maths in Minutes with Priya, please do so. It's absolutely free. I hope you are liking these videos and this new method of solving time and work examples. It's very easy, and we have avoided all fraction calculations. So let's meet in part 4 now. Till then, stay happy, stay blessed. Bye for today.